plain onion chowder with white sauce. Captain of Industry. See, it says Bundry right here. Ruthless visit. Yeah, been through that.
Run! It's the witch's curse!
Warning. Back pressure in the pipes is well past safe levels. All employees, leave the grounds immediately.
Your last warning. If you are anywhere in the vicinity of Rothwild Slaughterhouse, get out now.
Huh? You're not done yet, assassin. What about the shrines? Tell me about the blood rituals.
Okay, got away.
Here you are! Assassin, help! Get behind him! Die, Sharon!
Blacklight. Cut that man's head off like carving. Yes. Dowd was an expert cake carver before he turned to the more lethal blade.
Run, if you value.
Thank you. Let's go. I'm worried they sent for the hounds.
Hounds.
Is your last warning.
Think you'll get your own swamp back after what happened last night? Never doubt.
Is anything bothering you, Dowd? I've seen you kill a man without ruffling his hair. You took out the whole neighborhood. Barrister Timsh lives up in the legal district. I know it pretty well. From what I hear, the Timsh family is practically at war with itself. Talk to his niece Tali if you can. I should probably tag along when you go. Crazy rich people are buying up a lot of that Sokolov security technology these days. Keeps the weepers and looters out. I might be useful.
Not yet.
Did I not finish the recipe? Guess not.
Checking out.
Assassin, help!
How's it going? Rat poison. Well, that's rude. Mark Dean, 11 months. Almost a year. Good times. I'm glad. Thank you for the continued support. Where did I see that? She's flawless. Whole Weeper. I like half a Weeper.
Run, if you value your lives at all. Run! Run, if you value your lives at all. Run!
So many. Billy Lurk. She has to be so embarrassed to know me right now. There. Or is it? Might be the guy, the voices. It's hard to tell. I was gonna say, I know I can grab onto that.
Ready to go?
Billy's your mother name? Wilhelmina. I see. Wilhelmina. That was, I did hear that name earlier. So yeah, that makes sense.
Let's go.
Overall chaos. Yeah, a little bit. That's fair. Legal district. Eminent domain. Delilah once painted portraits for Barrister Arnold Timsh. A corrupt aristocrat who uses his legal powers to evict families from their homes and claim property for the Lord Regent based on false accusations of plague. Barrister Timsh's niece, Talia, hates him. She has promised to help you locate Delilah for a price. Meet with Talia to find out what she knows.
As a young girl, Delilah was a baker's apprentice in Dunwall Tower. Years later, a painter in Sokolov's circle. Barrister Arnold Timsh paid her to paint portraits. Him, I knew. a nobleman, born rich. And now he was making a second fortune, seizing the assets of plague victims for the Lord Regent. But Barrister Timps was also fighting a private war with his own niece. Something to do with the family fortune. Lurk was probably right. We needed to speak with the niece first. Her feud with the old barrister was something we could use. I got a message to the barrister's niece, and she claimed to know things about Delilah that no one else did. But the knowledge would have a price. I wasn't surprised. I went to meet her.
Stun mines. Adorable. Do that. Do that. You know what? No. Over there being a badass.
One more body shouldn't matter, right? Talia should be waiting in Trevor's Close. It's an alley just past the Wall of Light. You'll know it by three whitewashed skulls.
Did what, by accident? What did I do? Like a, oh, I see. Yeah. Yeah. As requested. Appreciate it. 4. I see. I mean, I could do that. Or I could increase. I want to increase my blink, I think. I'll increase my blink.
Founder of the Rothwild Slaughterhouse has been killed by enemies of the state while heroically attempting to prevent an act of sabotage. Be vigilant and report suspicious persons to the city watch.
Something about skulls. It's a swarm. You sure you want to? All over the place.
Who's paying for those clothes?
Wrong person. If I knew you, I would strong enough to go leaving while you still can.
Really? Where do you live? Probably some mansion on Clavering, right? Come on, let's have it. Before I start cutting.
I'm telling you now, walk away. Go home. You're making a mistake.
Oh, yeah? How so?
I'm here to meet a man named Dowd.
Get him, boys! Come on! Let's get...
Ow.
Get on with the rat face. Gotcha!
I didn't realize there were three of them.
Look at you, the master assassin. So you want to know about Delilah? Well, my uncle is bewitched by her, so we won't tell you anything. I require only two things. Get rid of my uncle, and bring me his last will and testament. In exchange, I'll tell you what you want to know about Delilah Copperspoon. And I'll pay you cold hard coin for your trouble. Come back to me when it's done. Let's meet at the docks when you return.
Butter on ice? Wouldn't they just make frozen butter? That's not very smooth. I don't... Hate everything. Hate everything even more. Yes, I'll get that bone charm. If I can figure out how. Shitting me. It's fine. Didn't even want to get up there. Choke dust, powerful irritant, can be thrown. Noxious cloud. Yes, good. Seems like a perfect book to use while you poop. I'm glad you enjoy it, Tommy. I enjoy it as well. It is very soft. Red Shore Chamber of Commerce. Once the financial heart of the Empire, the Red Shore Financial District was a hive of trade activity. No district employed more barristers, accountants, or indeed more security. And no part of Dunwall saw greater flow of coin. When the flood barriers broke and the waters rolled in, the looting that followed was accompanied by an epic period of chaos and butchery. Those who could withdraw and move their assets did what they could. Others, with their wealth tied up in grand mansions and artwork, lost it all. When the last of the high society set had withdrawn and the lights went dark, Red Shore was a gloomy, crumbling shell of what it had been. Inhabited by thieves, wild dogs, and rats, once great palaces of commerce sat empty and haunted, or came to house killers and mercenaries, as well as anyone else looking to hide from the city watch. In mere months, the flooded district was settled upon as the most proper name for the place. I did make a shirt's command. Hatters. Well-dressed kings of the low streets. The following is reconstructed from a discourse with a street person I encountered in a disreputable whiskey house while incognito. The hatters used to run all the rackets around Dunwall. Whiskey, weapons, hound fights. Whatever the game, the hatters had a big stake in it. Then the plague came and told the whole damn city apart. All that chaos led to new bosses cropping up. Most were shit heels that didn't last a week, but there were some hard cases like Lizzie Stride, Jim Dundermore and Black Sally, Aunt Slackjaw. His Bottle Street boys took the whiskey distillery from the Hatters and started pumping out bootleg elixir. That kicked off a gang war that made all the alleys red with blood. Problem was the Hatters, were getting it from all sides. The dead eels were pinching all the river smuggling deals. The butchers were driving us out of Slaughterhouse Row. We were bleeding from dozen different cuts. That is not grammatically correct. Losing some of our best guys. So we pulled back, just for a little while. As always, anyone who counts the Hatters out is two trumps short of a full deck of Nancy. What? The boss is a real devious son of a bitch. Been around since before the Caldwins. But I ain't talking about him. Hatters don't talk about the geezer. Even ex-Hatters. Note, despite my lavish bribery, the man refused to speak further on the subject. In fact, it became obvious that I had aroused his suspicion by that point, so I was forced to make my escape from the establishment. Scholar Joella Burgess, Academy of Natural Philosophy, Historical Annex. Yeah, Nancy is a game. I'm curious how that would function. Does this... Okay, good. Alright. God damn it, Granny. Cruel Nancy. Take the world from her greedy hands. Lay it before the black-eyed groom, cut sharp, cut deep. Red drip, drop. Last and least, burn it in the hearth of a lawless man. Do this for me, dearie, and I'll give you a birthday treat. The world from her greedy hands. So I... Take care, Miss Pyra. That's fine.
Well, eat something, or are you drunk? Wonder what got this guy.
Down.
What the fuck are you looking at?